Society has been witnessing an increase in average life expectancy over time due to advances in medicine, technology, hygiene, among others. But why do we age? Let's look at what happens at the cellular level in more detail. The cell is the smallest unit that constitutes living beings. Inside the nucleus of each cell, we have DNA, which is responsible for carrying all the genetic information. Without changing the DNA, we can obtain different cell responses, a process called epigenetics. Let's imagine that DNA works like a computer and epigenetics operates like a software that reads and processes this information. Contrary to popular belief, recent studies suggest that epigenetics play a more important role in aging than DNA. This new theory proposes that some genes that were supposed to be turned off are turned on and vice versa, a process mediated by epigenetics in response to the environment that surrounds us. But when do we start to age? Is it at 60? We actually start aging much earlier. Teenagers, children, and even fetuses in the womb are already in an aging process. However, in our youth, we have the ability to correct the mistakes that result in aging. But how can we be sure that we start aging so early? Is it possible to measure aging? The answer is yes. We can estimate biological aging by quantifying methyl groups included in one of the bases of our DNA, cytosine. The more methyl groups exist in cytosines, the faster we age. This is why we can say that the aging process starts so early in life. We accept aging as part of the natural course of life, in which we progressively lose functions. How can we increase the number of years in which we have quality of life and age healthier? Although aging is inevitable, we can have an impact on the quality of our life through exercise, healthy eating, and quality sleep. Do you want to find out more about healthy aging? Visit our website at erachair.uc-biotech.pt.